Like a lot of other people, I have been spending crazy amount of hours in Far Cry 6 in the last couple of weeks. That is, if you think that 10 hours a week is crazy, but despite actually really enjoying the game, it made me think about other open world games and why I don't enjoy them as much as I used to. When I start an open world game and get to explore the map freely for the first time, it reminds me of how I used to feel as a kid in the candy store. Or as an adult me in a candy store, it's honestly still the same feeling. All I want to do is run around like some marathon runner that just had 10 cups of coffee. Go away, fancy car, all I need is my 2 drumsticks and I'm good to go, and it's because I encounter everything for the first time, so it's exciting and I don't want to stop and exit my vehicle every 5 seconds, it just feels counterproductive. I want to see it all, and if I start driving past everything at 100 potato fields an hour on a fancy car, I feel like it ruins those magical moments. Especially if those moments feel earned and organic, when the game rewards you for being curious, and I don't mean it in scan every inch of the map for collectibles kind of way, but more about the things I ran into while free roaming, and every time I see something interesting I feel compelled to stop and check it out. It's like, when I get this super urgent mission to save someone in 3 minutes of traveling distance, you know damn well that I will get there an hour late because I ran into 3 military bases along the way, so I obviously stopped to shoot some people in the face, went hunting for ducks, shot some more people in the face, climbed a cool tower I passed next to, sniped some people in the face from it. Huh, I think I just really like shooting people in the face. Map feels immersive when you discover it organically, when things happen regardless of your presence, especially when you mix it up with satisfying gameplay. You can drive around and see soldiers and rebels fighting each other, and you can choose to stop and help or keep driving, but even cooler is when you make things happen instead of being an observer. I was driving to a mission and saw an NPC next to a broken car. Because I'm sane, decent, and definitely not a bloodthirsty man, I stopped, got out of my car, grabbed my M60, my repair tool, and fixed his car because I was curious to see what happens, and he thanked me by giving me money. This seems like a small thing because, well, Far Cry games have been doing this trope since Far Cry 3. I think I didn't play the first 2 Far Cry games, but the point is, I decided to do it, there was no mission marker and the game rewarded me for being curious. But then I saw it again. And again. And again. So at this point I started noticing the flaws and inconsistencies and the cracks started to form, just like in other beautiful open world games I played previously. Those cracks are usually small at first, but the longer you play, the more noticeable they become. In Far Cry 6 I was introduced to guerrilla roads that are basically dirt paths that run throughout the whole map and they act as a safe haven from soldiers. I expected that like in previous Far Cry games I would be attacked on sight, which to be fair was getting old after a while, and I thought that those roads would provide an interesting player choice. Safety versus speed, and I was actually really excited about it, but then I quickly realized that unless I actively look for confrontation, I'm not gonna get it, and those paths don't provide any gameplay advantage, so after a couple of hours I would choose the fastest possible route every single time. Same goes for a lot of other open world games. After you play it for a while and you're no longer in dire need of resources, traveling becomes another mindless thing that you just have to endure. Unless you don't. At this point I usually start using fast travel, and for me it's always a bad sign. There are only a handful of open world games I didn't use fast travel in. The GTA series, the Spider-Man series, and Minecraft. Wait, isn't Minecraft even an open world game? You know what? Doesn't matter, you get my point. I didn't use fast travel in GTA games because of 2 reasons. First of all, it wasn't an immediate solution, you still need to find or call a cab and pay the driver. Not that money is ever an issue, but most of all because traversing is so damn fun. It happened to me way too many times that I was on my way to an objective and got into a traffic accident, so I had to switch cars, but then a cop spotted me, so I shot him. Fast forward 3 minutes and instead of going to the marker on the map, I am on a rampage in a tank, and after eventually losing the cops, I go home and play some GTA 5. Basically, GTA acts like a semi-sandbox game, so you feel unsensitized to skip the travel because the world is so alive, dynamic, and always interesting. Same goes for Spider-Man games. Swinging through New York was made so damn well, with an added bonus in form of having a learning curve. Unlike some games where you can hold X to follow the road, you have to actively participate, and how well and fast you swing depends entirely on you, so you always feel engaged. But unfortunately in most games it's not the case. Even when playing Horizon Zero Dawn, a game I absolutely loved, I was using fast travel all the time because seeing the same places and randomly getting attacked from time to time does get old eventually. As for interest points, I do appreciate that I can have them on my map. As a trophy hunter, I hate having to rely on guides, but when I see too many of them at the same time, it can get overwhelming and drive players to ignore them entirely. Or even worse, ruin your immersion, because instead of exploring a beautiful game, you just end up following a blue line. Game that handled it well in my opinion is Spider-Man Miles Morales. Despite points of interest being on the map, you can still traverse the city organically because they just give you a sense of direction instead of acting like Apple Maps. Also, they appear gradually as you progress with the story missions, so as long as you explore just a bit between said missions, it never gets out of hand. Either way, in most open world games, if you want to complete everything, get all the trophies and clear 100% of the map, you need to get ready for the monotony. Look, I'm all in for more content, especially the optional kind, but if said content doesn't add value, then it probably shouldn't be in the game. You can add hundreds of collectibles and side missions, but when there is not enough variety, it just becomes boring. Let's take a look at GTA 5 again. There is a lot of content in the single player part of it, and yes, some collectibles are pretty boring. I wanted to blow my brains out when I was collecting the nuclear waste in the submarine, but the side missions are really exciting. The best example I can think of is the Keflom storyline. In case you're not familiar, there is a series of side missions where you, as Michael, can join a cult, but the best part is how you actually find those side missions. It's not by going to the marker on the map, it's by browsing the in-game internet on your phone and making a donation on a random website, which in return sends you down the rabbit hole of cool, exciting and very different style missions that break the monotony, and as an added bonus you can discover it organically by interacting with the game world, and this is the type of side content that I want. Now obviously not every developer is Rockstar Games. This is not the point, but the point is, if you want your game to be fun enough to complete, in a 100% completion type sense, it has to be unique enough to be justified. And even some great games like Horizon Zero Dawn do fail in that to some extent. Most of the side missions just end up repeating the same structure over and over again. Basically talk to an NPC, travel to a marker on the map, scan the environment, follow the clues and fight some machines, which, don't get me wrong, can still be a lot of fun because of the solid gameplay, but it doesn't add anything new to the table, so it becomes another checkbox monotonous task. As for Far Cry 6, I think it does a decent enough job in that department because of the fun gameplay, but yes, missions are still fairly repetitive, especially the side stuff, and I found that the right tool for the right job did miss the mark, because although I can see what they were trying to do, for me the right tool for every job was a silent sniper rifle paired with a silenced M16 and some explosives, just in case things go south, and I practically completed the whole game like this, so by the end of it, it did become quite repetitive. And yes, I'm aware that it's partially my fault, but unless I'm given a compelling reason to change my playstyle, I will stick with whatever works, and I believe that most gamers will too. Now it might seem like I'm hating on the open world games in general and Far Cry 6 in particular, but it's not really the case, I just believe that it's all about the balance. The problem with the balance though, it's very difficult to get it right. Let's take Mafia Definitive Edition as the next example. It is technically a linear story game, but it does offer a free ride mode where you can freely explore said map and mess around. The problem is, there's almost nothing to do in the city of Lost Haven. Yes, there are technically some side missions there, but I couldn't care less, I just did what I had to do and moved on to the next game. What I'm getting at is, there has to be a balance between quality and quantity in the side content to make the map clear and worth it. I like longer games with a ton of things to do, but doing those things have to be fun, not overdone, and the traversal between objectives needs to be engaging, otherwise you end up with a checklist of things to do and you find yourself fast traveling between those interest points to get to 100% completion, and it's plain boring. And because this was my experience with a lot of open world AAA games lately, I found myself shying away from them and going for more linear stories instead. But the thing is, because I still love exploration, I can never stay away for too long, and I think that despite the flaws, those games are still definitely worth playing and completing, Far Cry 6 included, but maybe pacing myself is necessary. Let me know, do you prefer open world games or linear games? Also, if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to me as I make gaming related videos at least once a week. Thank you for watching.